Good day, fellow investor. I will start today with a quiz prepared by Warren Buffett himself. The first question: if you plan to eat hamburgers throughout your life and are not a cattle producer, should you wish for higher or lower prices for beef? Likewise, if you're going to buy a car from time to time but are not an auto manufacturer, should you prefer higher or lower car prices? These questions, of course, answer themselves. And now the final exam. Please be ready. If you expect to be a net saver during the next 5 years, should you hope for a higher or lower stock market during that period? So, if we look at headlines, they are all negative, in really putting panic into people's heads. They look at their portfolio, it's in the red, it's declining, and people start to get nervous, itchy. However, the real answer, the real feeling should be one of, whoa, stocks are crashing, yeah! You should be very happy and thankful that stocks are crashing. Now, are you convinced? I don't think so. So let me show you a few examples of how things work, because an investor, and probably 99.9% of you, want to accumulate wealth over the long term. You know that short-term trading, yes, might lead to something, but you burn out usually after 2-3 years and then you forget about investing. However, long-term wealth builders, those who really want to get something out of the stock market, will really appreciate what I'm going to show you. I have created 3 scenarios, one where the stock market continues to go up, steadily up 4% per year, one where it stays flat, and one where it crashes 70% and then it goes up by 10% per year, but ends after 10 years still below the current level. Under the assumption that we invest a constant amount of money per year, you will see which one would end up better. At the end, I will make the same calculation for those who already have, let's say, $500,000 in stock now, and how even for them, a stock market crash would be beneficial. Sounds crazy, bear with me, the numbers don't lie. Alright, if the S&P 500 grows linearly for the next 10 years at a rate of 4%, which is the current earnings yield, in 2027 it would be at 3,771 points. If we constantly invest 5,500 per year, after 10 years you would have accumulated 17.5 shares of the S&P 500. That would give you wealth of $66,033. Which is not bad, as you have invested $55,000 over the last 10 years. Assuming the same dividend as the current for the S&P 500, your yearly dividend would be $839 per year. Scenario number 2. The S&P remains flat for the next 10 years. $5,500 per year would allow you to accumulate 20.75 shares of the S&P 500, and your yearly dividend after 10 years would be $995. I have excluded dividends from the calculations to keep things simple and increase the earnings yield. So at the end, it turns out the same. In the first scenario, let's assume the S&P 500 crashes 70% this year to a level of 795 points, which would imply a price earnings ratio of 7.42 and an earnings yield of 13.47. Assuming that the S&P 500 grows by 13.37% over the next 10 years, over the next 9 years, the value of it would be 2,220 points in 2027, which is still, what, 15% lower than current levels. So this would be the worst case scenario. If you are invested now, you would be underwater in the next 10 years. However, if you keep investing 5,500 per year or whatever your monthly or yearly investment is, you would find yourself with 41.41 shares of the S&P 500 for a value of $91,955, which is the best result in these scenarios. And the dividend that is double the previous scenario of $1,986 per year. So even if the S&P 500 would be lower than it is now during the whole next 10 years and still end lower, if you are constantly investing your money over time, you would end up richer with a lower S&P 500. So it's very counterintuitive, difficult to explain to people, but low stock prices make you rich. Warren Buffett became rich in the 1960s and 70s when there were extreme bargains to buy and to deploy his capital. And he took advantage of low stock prices. He was buying like hell in 1982. And that's what gave him later the capital, the investment power to do what he has done. However, his return on investment have been lower, lower and lower as he grew, but also as normal investment returns, interest rates went lower. So something very important to keep in mind. You get rich when stocks are cheap, not when stocks are expensive. You might temporarily do good, feel excited, like cryptocurrencies or whatever, but at the end, after a year, 2 or 5 years, the story doesn't end well. Now you might say, okay, but I have already so much money invested, what if that goes away? Well, let's see a case where we invest $5,500 per year, we have already $500,000 in stocks, 1.81% is the dividend yield, which means that we get additional $9,000 per year in dividends and we reinvest that money. So in that case, we reinvest $14,100 per year, and assuming the S&P 500 crashes 70% this year and then grows per 13.7% per year over the next 10 years, thus ends up at a lower level than now in 2027, you, thanks to your investments, you start with 188 shares of the S&P 500 as you have $500,000 in it, and you add another 106 shares. In total, you would end up with 294 shares, which would be valued at that point in time, $654,703. So you would still make money even in a downturn environment. And the dividend would be $14,142 with lower stock prices. However, if nothing changes, you still invest $14,100 per month, the S&P continues to go higher and ends up at $3,771, then you would end up with 233 shares of the S&P 500, thus about, what, 60 less. The value would be higher, but the dividend would be lower, as you are expected to live off the dividend and you never know where the stock market will be in 2027. I would pick scenario number one, where stocks crash, even if I have $500,000 now. Might sound crazy, but you want to invest, you want to create wealth, you want to create wealth that's not paper wealth, that's actual owning business, dividends, cash flows, passive income, wealth building over the long term. Therefore, look at the numbers, calculate them for yourself from where you are, and rejoice when stock prices crash, because you can buy more of the good things you already own for a lower price. It's crazy that people panic when stock prices crash, but people get excited when there is a discount at that store or something like that, or when you're negotiating with your neighbor about that, I don't know, fire hose or whatever, you're so happy when you lower the price by 10. Why aren't you when you can buy cheaper stocks? When you learn that lower stock prices are better, you are an investor and you will do extremely well in your lifetime. Just to end on a personal note, my best investment returns came from buying when things were cheap, extremely cheap. I had the fortune to start investing in 2002 in a frontier market, which was Croatia. That was too easy. I ended up quintupling my money in the next 5 years. I lost some money in 2008 as I was invested. However, in 2009 and 2010-11, I really invested heavily, continued to add money, and then again in the next 3-4 years quintupled my money. 2015, 14, end of 2014, real estate prices in the Netherlands were very cheap. I could take a mortgage, I had some money, I put it in a real estate prices, and I didn't quintuple. Well, if you don't calculate the mortgage, I again quintupled my money, but that's a different story as it's still a paper winning. So we are not planning to sell in the short term. So for now it's a paper gain, but again, I bought when prices were really, really cheap. And in the quarter that I bought my house in the Netherlands, there were only 1,700 transactions in the region. Now the number is above 17,000 per quarter. So huge difference. I bought when nobody wanted houses. Nobody wanted stocks when I was buying, everybody was selling. And that did well for me. And even if I took a loss in 2008, even if I took losses when stock prices fell in 2009, 2010, 11, because I was constantly buying, and stocks were volatile, let's say, I did well over the long term. So rejoice, lower stock prices, even if you are 50 and rich, because when you will be 60, you will be happy. Thank you for watching, looking forward to your comments, and I'll see you in the next video.